Going on, guys? Brilliance here, bringing you a showing off of my new mob chamber type of survival environment that I just created. Well, not just, but a couple days ago I finished this, and it's just where the subject or testee enters consecutive rooms, and basically the number of mobs in the so-called mob bomb, if you can see my air quotes here. The number of the mobs progressively increases until you reach the final room, which is called the boss room, which has some lightning creepers. So that's always a nice surprise for the subject. So here I got my friend Jox200. Oh, by the way, I am also playing in Chef's Craft. I'll leave the IP in the description. This is the server that I play on most of the time now. But so my subject is Jox200, and in the beginning here you saw the sped up version of me outfitting him with his armor and stuff. And one change that I did want to make to that was instead of giving the subject diamond armor, I think I'm going to change it to iron, just because they seem to survive most scenarios. And I would like it to be progressively more difficult. So basically the materials they get is a bow with a stack of arrows, an iron sword, and then diamond armor along with food so that they can keep healing up. But here you actually saw the creepers that I, five creepers actually that I spawned in the mob bomb, as you saw before. Those actually take out a lot of the mobs, which is another change I'm going to do, as maybe not including as many creepers, maybe like one, because creepers actually kill more mobs than the actual player does with their explosions. So as you see here, Jox passed level 1, which is fairly simple. Because of the array of those stone stairs, the player has the advantage over the mobs, because the mobs have to jump here. And you'll see here that later in the video the brightness goes up, because I was recording in a really dark room, which is actually part of the third chamber, as I like to call it. So this level 2 is the ruins, as you maybe read on the signs before. And to build this room, I literally just flew around the room at about 1.5 times speed and just started laying down random crap that out of like 3 blocks that I chose, like half block stairs and otherwise. So Jox here is doing a really good job. He is he said that in either the second or third room that he only had 2 hearts down from his original full health. So when he said that, I actually decided to lower the quality of the armor that the subject receives, because they should definitely be taking more damage than just 2 hearts. So here you see him defeat the last of the zombies, doing a good job there, and I'm just kind of standing here as admin. Oh, by the way, in Chef's Craft, I was recently made admin about like a week ago or half a week or something like that, and it's been awesome. So Top Chefs 11, or actually 11 Top Chefs, the owner of the server, if you're watching this, thank you for making me admin. I really appreciate it, and I assure you that I will not abuse such a position. So here Jox wanted his diamond sword back, and I basically said, hey dude, if you survive, then I'll enchant it for you. And he was like, whatever. So he kept his iron sword, and we move on to the next chamber. So this is level 3, and it's called In the Dark, and it is called In the Dark for a reason. That's part of the that's part of the challenge of this chamber, actually, is that you can barely see anyone. And for some reason, he threw these watermelon at me, and I was like, dude, what the heck? So yeah, here you see the brightness get inched up so that you, the viewers, can actually see things. So I'm speeding up through the spawning of the mobs here, because it gets quite laggy, and it does take quite a while as I count out, like, so many creepers and zombies and stuff. So in a minute here, you'll see that I release the bomb, and then Jox goes to work on these mobs. So one thing I wanted to talk about in this video too was that I will also be releasing maybe like 2 more videos of my golden sword arena that I've built. Oh my gosh, look at this lag. I think there were like 30 zombies, 30 skeletons, and like 10 creepers in that. But look at that creeper explosion. It just took out at least a third of the mobs there. So one thing I did want to talk about was future videos, where I'll probably be posting like 2 videos, where one of them will be showing my mob arena, which is straight up survival, where you just enter an iron door and you just fight until you die, basically. And I don't know, I mean, I think that would seem fun, but then again, I have god mode and unlimited diamond swords and enchants, so And then the other thing I wanted to talk about was my Golden Sword Arena, which I've completed, and I'm really curious to see how those arenas will work out, since I haven't really experimented yet in the server with that. Improvements will have to be made on the rules on the arena and such. But yeah, so expect those two videos where I'm just showcasing new game modes that I've invented myself this past week, where I've built all three, actually. The town where I built all these arenas in is called Soviet Russia, which I think is pretty funny. So, cause Soviet Russia just seems awesome, because it's all about fighting and brutality and where everyone is poor. No, I'm just kidding. There isn't really a town, but my friend Will was actually thinking about building a town outside of Soviet Russia, which I was like, whatever. But so yeah, he's already actually built a cathedral there. So right here, Jock completes level 3 in the dark room, and I actually tell him that he's okay to advance, but he's like, no, dude, you forgot a skeleton. And I was like, whatever, because this room spawns mobs all the time, and usually you can't just kill all the mobs, because usually one spawns while you're out killing the other one that might be there. So here we go, congrats, next chamber, onto the boss room. Oh, and right there in that little frame, you can see the owner, Top Chefs, just kind of checking out what I'm doing here. And right here's the boss room. It says, "Ah, hell nah," on the sign, which I think is pretty funny. I invented that myself. So the boss room up here consists of 40 skeletons, 40 zombies, and I think like 10 creepers. But in future run-throughs of this progression chamber, I'm going to take out the creepers, as I said before, because they just kill a lot of mobs and takes out some of the fun and challenge. So yeah, so right here I'm just loading up the mob bomb, speeding it up. I think it's like 4 times. And Jox actually starts out this room outside of the room, and I was like, dude, I just released the bomb, get in here. So I just teleported him in, and he started going to work, and it was pretty amusing. And I think he's still back in that room, and creepers, I don't know, some sort of creeper just blew up. So yeah, so there he is. I'm going to release it in a little bit. Just said go. And as you can see, those things just fly out of there, and they, oh, actually, yeah, he didn't even, oh, and right there, sorry, I keep pointing out stuff, but right there you actually saw that I tried to lightning those creepers before they would die, which that didn't really turn out very good. Neither did this attempt right here, where I try to lightning them and then take out the bottom of the bomb, except that they just die right away, and I was like, ah, oh, dang it, that would have been fun to mess with them like that. And then later, once he kills pretty much all of the mobs, as I teleport him back there, I just start spawning creepers and skeletons, and then he dies, and he was like, oh, no fair. He started spawning stuff, and I was like, eh, that's how it works, buddy. So that was pretty amusing. So in the next 20 seconds or so, you'll see him die, and he was really mad because I said, if you win, you basically get an enchantment on your sword, and he also asked for some glass pane, so I was like, whatever. But yeah, right here, you see me spawn a bunch of creepers on the bridge, and I think that's how he gets blown up, is these last, like, 5 creepers there. So, yep, right there, he just died. And, so, yeah, all was well that ends well, actually. It turns out I just gave him, I just let him keep his diamond armor that I spawned for him, and, whatever other materials that he wanted. And for some reason, Minecraft just turned randomly bright right here. I was like, did Fraps just freak out on me or something? But it turned out okay. And, yeah, he just got killed again. And I was like, wow, dude, herp derp, you don't just, I don't know, you just, that was really funny. So, yeah, this is the end of the video, guys. Thanks for watching, have an awesome day. Hope to see you in another video. Please subscribe and or like, if you wish. So, peace.